So Gripen E looks a lot like Gripen C, but it's a completely different aircraft, and it does completely new different things in a new way. So the biggest difference is really the sensor suite. So we have all these new sensors. We have a new active passive electronically scanned array radar, and we have invested heavily in electronic warfare apertures. So we have 5 antenna systems on the airframe, 40 different apertures, which provides you with spherical active passive coverage. Then you get all this data, so you have to find new clever ways to present it to the pilot. So we have introduced a new cockpit design, so the new wide area display, fully customizable depending on the mission and your own personal preferences. So you can do set it up depending on your mission. So for instance, a large force air-to-air Bell visual range mission would use much bigger speed lighters.
You have a lot of
new automation, so which helps the pilot to keep the workload at manageable level.
So basically you can set it in this widescreen and
Set it in many different kinds of configurations as you want, and most of the time you can do this as before you go flying in your mission planning phase. So you preload all the settings for you, and then you just upload it when you go flying. So your own symbol in the middle, and then you have your other Gripen members here. The fully networked system. So all the sensors on all the platforms, all the Gripens work automatically together to create situational awareness with all the sensors. So in this particular scenario, you will have now some targets coming up here in the north. So these can be detected by the Gripen sensors or a system such as AeriEye or GlobalEye, which also the Thai Air Force. So these particular missions here, these tracks have been generated by command and control. So I'm flying completely passively. So I'm not emitting anything with any active sensors. And this is the default set to operate. So you'd fly in a formation with passive sensors so that no one will be able to see that you are coming. And then you just build a situation.
So do you gonna shoot them? Do you gonna shoot them down?
Yes, I'm going to do it now.
Okay.
So now I'm selecting that target. So I will see the threat missile of that target. So I know that when I get inside this, it will be a little bit dangerous. So I will now select my own weapon, which is the Meteor long range, long mission range missile. So it's well inside my weapon engagement zone, which is this green area here. So I'm not going to fire a missile at him. Like that. You can see the missile fire. And you will also on my screen, you will see the missile fire out, line and the missile fire. So I'm now going to start turning away from this target. So I'm going to start turning away, so I move away from the missile that he may have shot. In the real jet, this is a marketing simulator, you don't have all the decision support presentation. But in the real jet, you'll have all kinds of associated information about these tracks to know how successful your missile will be, what happens if the hostile aircraft will start turning away. You will have an indication of how good situation awareness quality you have. So the enemy might start jamming you with electronic warfare. So you will then see what happens and how that affects your situation awareness. And the network of Gripens and all the sensors will automatically track support everything. So you will always have a very robust quality and a robust situation awareness. Then we have introduced a whole new level of electronic attack. So our own ability to jam air targets and ground targets in a very efficient and new dynamic way. So if I get threatened by, for instance, if I get close to the surface-to-air missile area here, and they threatened me with a radar or a missile. All my Gripen wingmen in the formation will automatically start jamming that particular threat to maximize my survivability. A new tactical features with the network and all the sensor data we have. So conventional aircraft force and some fifth generation aircraft today, if you fire a missile at one target, you are always going to be supporting that missile with your own radar, your own sensor data. Now this is all changing. So one Gripen can fire a missile at a target from a long distance, turn away, while another Gripen, maybe 25, 30 miles away somewhere else, can now missile support, sensor support that missile with their sensor system. And this is a whole new way of doing it. And it will enable whole new ways of doing air-to-air tactics.
On the E-model?
Yes, on the E-model. So in the E-model, we do it already today. Similarly, looking at acquiring ground targets, you can do it in different ways. You can do it in passive ways with your radar, you can do it in active ways. So new ways of looking at threats at the distance with passive sensors and picking up coordinates so you can set fire air-to-ground missiles. Even at targets that and radar systems that are not looking at you at that time. So whole new situation awareness, higher level situation awareness, new decision support that helps the pilot to keep the workload low, which we have put a lot of emphasis in perfecting. So this is the concept of Gripen. And now we are also integrating complex weapons suites, so we can do suppression of enemy and transmission types, destruction of enemy. So we are now looking at complex weapons, network weapons, smart seekers, so to do the very complex missiles, so to be ready for the scenarios and fight for the future.
On the rare occasion, if the large display broke down,
this one?
Mm-hmm. Yes. Mm-hmm. How can you fly the jet?
Yeah. So there are different ways of doing it. So the wide area display is the display is being generated by several display processes. So if one fails, you still will have the presentation. If the whole wide area display as such will break, then you might still have the head-up display to fly the aircraft. And if that fails, you will always have the small head-down displays, one on the left and one on the right. So you can always return to your base, and even in bad weather, so you can do an instrument approach on any of these small head-down displays. So there is a lot of redundancy built into the system as well, as it's those airworthiness features that we take very seriously.
What is the key difference between the CD model and the E model?
So it's the situational awareness you get because of a whole new sensors in the system. And then the powerful electronic warfare that gives you whole new ways of managing the battle and surviving the battle in the future fighting. Already today, but the next 15, 25, 30 years. So this is what we do.
So all the electronic warfare things is built in the aircraft, not in the pod? Or?
Well, you can put another pod in if you want to expand it, but it's not necessary really for the most missions. So every Gripen will have a very capable electronic warfare system already built in the system. So recording terabytes of data at all time when you fly. It is, you can say that platform like Gripen is now a flying combat ISTAR platform, so which records and just vacuums all the data at all times when you're flying. So you will have terabytes of data to take care of. Then another distinction which we have also worked a lot on the Gripen E model is how we have designed the system's architecture. So the new avionics, which allows you to go into parts of the avionics system to change things very quickly. Conventional design, you always have to do a lot of verification, validation when you upgrade or change things. But now we have one partition in the avionics where the air forces can go with their own own programmers or coders and take all this mission data, change it, and then reload, upload very quickly within hours, within days. And this is a whole new setup, which many aircraft design authorities now have started talking about. Like we already have it now today. It's the future sensor data, and many of the smart scientists and smart generals and officers, they talk about treating your sensor data as a weapon. And it's a little bit abstract to understand, but we have built in the system in the avionics to be able to do that in a very quick way.
One last thing. You know, we lost one Gripen due to the practical of the pilot.
Yes, that's right.
And we now upgrade with the new version that the computer can maneuver when the pilot unconscious.
Yes.
I don't know if you can demonstrate this in here.
Yeah. So in this particular jet, we don't have all the features that Gripen C already today and Gripen E will have. And I'm talking about automatic recovery, so automatic ground collision avoidance. But we can demonstrate something that will show you a little bit of the awareness that you will get. But this particular market, it's a marketing simulator, doesn't have all the features. So it will have the warnings, but if the pilot is unconscious, the real jet will recover and save the pilot's life. And we have had these functions in many of our jets for quite a long time. Let's see, I will demonstrate something. So soon when we get much closer to the ground, we'll get a lot of warnings advising the pilot of now it's the time to pull up. So you'll get a lot of warnings, pull up, a lot of symbols screaming in your helmet and showing you what to do and when to do it. Now in this particular event, it didn't function. Let's try it. And in the real jet, you'll get all these warnings, and also the aircraft will sense that the pilot is not doing anything, and then it will recover automatically to save the pilot's life. Auto GCAS, automatic ground collision avoidance system. See if we can get it working on this. Not everything is implemented in this simulator.
Pull up.
There you have an example of this. You will have an automatic recovery like this, saving the pilot's life.
Okay.
In a certain specific, if you have a very steep angles, like in, for instance, in air displays, it will do what it can to save the pilot's life. But if you are going really fast, you will be in ballistic, so it might not always work. But it's depending on the different flying conditions that you have.
One last question.
Yes,
commonality between the C model and the E model.
Yeah.
What is the common thing that the pilot can transfer from the C model to the E model?
Yes. So all the presentation, the normal flight dynamics, the presentation, and the stick and many of the cockpit items are the same, even though they do different things. Flying feels more or less the same way. So there will be a lot of recognition in the dynamics and movement of flight. It's a similar HMI design, even though we have completely new things that we can do. So a pilot that is transitioning from Gripen C to E will save a lot of time in terms of recognition. New capability of Gripen E and Gripen C, so which will be co-operated by the Swedish Air Force. So we do a lot of things also for a potential pilot moving on to Gripen E to interoperate between a Gripen C platform and Gripen E. So you can find the same information, use the same data link functionalities, so that you can use both platforms or both elite types in a much more optimal way. So interoperability between Gripen C and Gripen E, that's very important.
Thank you very much.
My pleasure.